The world has decided to stone me to death with prizes, congratulations, telegrams, and 7,000 letters. Obviously, there's not much I can do. However, those who punish me in this way should not expect to be thanked by their victim. Weeding fills my day. For me, in my present state of restlessness, it is a kind of opium to which I abandon myself for whole days. It is a task free of material considerations. Countless hours spent in the garden yield 3 or 4 baskets of vegetables. Gardening has a religious quality. Kneeling on the ground, pulling weeds, one celebrates a kind of rite that is continually renewed. Once I have finished clearing 3 or 4 flower beds, the first one is already thick with weeds again.
So hier und da im Gespräch, mehr nur nebenbei, hat er seine Arbeit erwähnt. Also meistens die Arbeit, an der er gerade arbeitet. So hat er mir zum Beispiel mal im Garten, wie wir beim Jätten waren, hat er mir gesagt, weißt du, die meisten Leute schauen das für eine sehr, sehr langweilige Arbeit an. Aber mir ist gar nicht langweilig. Beim Jätten, da ist ein großer Teil des Glasperlenspiels entstanden. Es ist eine Arbeit, die Hände sind beschäftigt, es braucht aber keine besondere Aufmerksamkeit und somit ist der Geist frei und kann arbeiten. Und zwar kann er so viel besser arbeiten, wenn die Hände mit irgendetwas mehr oder weniger mechanischem beschäftigt sind, als wenn man einfach so da sitzt und denkt, jetzt sollte etwas gehen.
I have not forgotten your letter. My eyes are strained and have been almost constantly painful for several years. My hands are deformed by arthritis and gout. Only grudgingly and clumsily do they allow me to write or type letter after letter. My eyes would prefer to look at flowers, kittens, or the verses of a poet rather than a letter. My hands would also prefer more pleasant pastimes for themselves. Age and sclerosis are advancing. Sometimes blood does not flow properly up to my brain. However, these problems also have a positive side. You stop hearing many things, and you stop feeling certain shocks and pains. Part of the being that once was called I is already where the whole will soon be.
Mein Vater hatte ein ziemlich genau festgelegtes Tagesprogramm, um 11 Uhr Post. Vorher war Gelegenheit, sei es mal im Garten, sei es irgendeine Arbeit, die er erledigt hat. Vor allem war er im Lauf des Vormittags auch für niemanden persönlich zu sprechen. Höchstens für seine Frau, für keinen Gast oder Besucher. Dann gab es Mittagessen und Kaffee. Das war die Zeit, wo er einen Gast empfing und zu Gesprächen bereit war. Abends war es in der Regel so, dass er nach dem Essen, das man gelesen hat, er legte sich hin und hörte sehr aufmerksam zu und entweder seine Gattin oder auch einer von den Söhnen hat vorgelesen. Es gab auch in seinem Programm hier und da angestrichen, im Radioprogramm, ein Konzert, das er hören wollte. Je nachdem, in welche Tageszeit es fiel, konnte der Gast oder Besuch oder Sohn, wer da war, konnte mithören.
One must be reconciled with old age and everything it brings with it. One must say yes to it. Without this yea, without submission to what nature demands of us, the worth and meaning of our days, whether we are old or young, are lost and we betray life. We demand that life should have meaning, but life has precisely the meaning that we wish to bestow on it. Life acquires meaning only through love. The more we are capable of love and dedication, the more our lives will be rich with meaning. Every kind of love and sharing enriches us, while every effort to possess material goods and power deprives us of strength and leaves us poorer. Oh, wisdom is all so simple. It has been expressed and stated so long ago. Why does it belong to us only in part? Why only on good days and not always? He was transformed. This time he had attained the right metamorphosis, the eternal metamorphosis, because what had been half had become whole. He could transform himself from one moment to the next, whenever and however he wanted. A magical current ebbed and flowed in his blood, and he became part of the internal process of creation that constantly renews itself. He turned into a stag, a fish, a man, and a snake, a cloud and a bird. In every form he was both one and a pair. He had within himself the sun and the moon, male and female. He flowed like twin currents through the land. He shone like a double star in the sky.
Signora Hesse mi telefonò la mattina che il marito non era sceso alla colazione ed era molto preoccupata per questo. In quel momento io sapevo che Hesse se n'era andato, perché non aveva più ritrovato quella sintonia che avevamo sempre avuto, si era bruscamente rotta. Mi sono precipitato e sono arrivato in casa Hesse, dove la signora ansiosa mi aspettava. Salì nel suo hortus conclusus, cioè il suo appartamento privato, del quale io solo avevo la chiave, e sono entrato e ho trovato Hesse disteso sul suo letto, sereno nella rigidità della morte. Nella sua mano sinistra aveva le confessioni di Sant'Agostino, che era rigato da un po' di sangue coagulato che era disceso dalla bocca. E restai lì assorto a vedere questo personaggio che mi era diventato tanto, tanto amico. Sulla scrivania c'era la sua ultima poesia, la terza versione, la versione definitiva prima della morte.
A branch, broken and split, dangling year after year, creaking its song to the wind with neither leaves nor bark, bare, wan, worn out by a long life and a long death. Its song echoes, cracking and persistent, stubbornly. It resounds with secret anguish for yet another summer, yet another winter.